Now, in one of our previous videos, I showed you how to make changes to some of the configurations after the fact. So after the installation, you can go in and change your Pi server or your email server this way, right? Well, how do you change the AF server that your instance of notifications is pointing to? That's actually something you can do from the Windows Explorer by configuring a flat ASCII file here. Now this is actually how you would go ahead and direct these different copies of notifications to the same AF server but for different databases. So for example, if you've got a box here that you've configured to be a secondary, or I shouldn't say secondary, but a second notification server, and this notification server is going to be going against this AF database, what you can do is through this configuration file, you'll notice you can have this server over here. This is going to process maybe AF database A and B on this server. And then this notification box over here can process databases C and D, all the notifications required. So that's in addition to specifying the actual different AF servers. You can actually specify which databases within a single AF server. So if you do have one of these, you know, when you want to scale this up and have multiple notification boxes out here, each and every one of these notifications boxes can point to a different, you know, set of things that need to be notified on the AF server. So let's take a look at how you would do that. You will find in the directory called Program Files PyPC Analytics, you'll find this configuration file. And if I open this up with Notepad, you can see it's a real simple configuration file in which we specify the name of the AF server and then the name or the list of the target databases. These would be the databases in that AF server for which notifications is currently generating alarms or generating notifications. In the case of what you see right here with just the two double quotes, that indicates we're doing all databases. And that's probably a good, you know, good way to keep that, unless you want to specifically identify exactly which databases within this AF server you're going to be doing notifications for. So that's going to be the name of the AF server, and this will effectively point, you know, this particular instance of notifications, the instance that's looking at this config file when it starts up, that's effectively setting that copy of notifications to be going to a different AF server. Now we've talked earlier about the need for some kind of better security domain user and password if you're going to be doing this on an AF server that's removed from notifications. So what we mean by that is if notifications is running, you know, on one machine and AF is on another, then on the notifications machine, you have to go into this right here, this Pi notification scheduler, and specify this to log on as a specific domain user. Now we had an opportunity to do that. If you recall during the installation, this is how you would do it after the installation has already been completed. You'd specify a domain account at this point. But remember, if AF and notifications are on the same machine, this isn't an issue. You shouldn't have to do this.